variable geometry turbo problems. Don't tell me you haven't had a turbo problem, because they're out there everywhere. Three types of turbo problems that we will typically see from the variable geometry customers are oil consumption. It's got bearings that have failed, maybe hot shutdowns or really extended drain intervals with dirty oil that's contaminated by carbon or wrong oil. Maybe you got a blocked crankcase filter and it's causing excessive pressure and pushing oil out the turbo. None of which are actually the turbo's fault, but outside sources that are causing that turbo to fail, and we need to get to the bottom of it and find out why the turbo's failing. You've got mechanical faults. You got a lot of pieces in the system that's feeding air into your turbocharger. It could be EGR valve problems, EGR cooler problems, coolant contamination, foreign object contamination. You know, it's got a mechanical fault. That turbo won't shift from a big turbo to a small turbo because it gets stuck in between because of bent fins or clogged up with that mixture of coolant and carbon. So those are mechanical faults. And then we've got electrical faults. A lot of these turbos have electric actuators on them that unfortunately electronics can fail. Let's hear from you guys. What are you seeing? What's your problem with your VGT turbo? Let us know. We've got access to all the manufacturers' service parts topics and bulletins and all the stuff the dealer's not going to give you. They don't mind selling you a $5,000 turbo, but they're not going to give you all the information to change it yourself, that's for sure, because they want that job in their shop. So from diagnosis through delivery, give us a shout, Highway and Heavy Parts, 844-447-1453. Leave a comment below. Let us know what your turbocharger problems are. Let us get to the bottom of it and fix your engine right.